wellness is the way forward. Since this pandemic started, we definitely have changed the way that we look at designing a house. A house should be a place that reinvigorates you, that makes you feel good, that makes you feel well. That's a fundamental part of a house succeeding as being a sanctuary and the place that you can really retreat to.
Rooftop gardens, internal courtyards, outdoor areas, massive windows that frame views. Nearly every project in Habitus House of the Year has an incredible connection to nature. I think it's a reflection of a truly innate human desire. There's so many studies that have repeatedly confirmed spending time in nature has immense health benefits. It makes sense that we're bringing these kinds of elements into our homes and into our everyday lives.
One of the projects we examined was the House Flower by Beresford Architects. This is a remarkable project because it demonstrates how by adding one large room, one very carefully and thoughtfully planned large room and a large deck, it has transformed a typical Sydney house into a wonderful place to live. And in front of this addition, there's a splendid jacaranda tree. It really provides the mood and the atmosphere of the place. It actually shelters the house. It provides dappled light in summer and, being deciduous, full sunlight in winter. A marvelous outcome.
Health and well-being is obviously very topical for everyone all around the world, and there are very few things that are easier to address this than how you cook your food at home. CombiSteam technology in cooking is a very efficient way to make sure you retain nutrients and retain flavors in your food, and you do it so in a very healthy way.
In terms of apartment buildings and smaller spaces within our cities and vertical spaces, it's really important to increase the amenity of those spaces. And we like to utilise ways where you can feel the whole volume of a space. It's less confined. We like to incorporate things like passive ventilation and spaces that you can break out to and guess link to the outside environment.
If there's something we learned from the last year and a half, it's that our home is our sanctuary, it's our space where we can really kind of unravel and just be. The furniture items that you choose and the mindful moments you have when you're sitting in them, it's the skincare products that you're selecting and have by your kitchen sink and your bathroom sink, so that you can have those moments of mindfulness where you can feel the product, smell the product, and of course it needs to be aesthetically pleasing as well.
We know how beneficial biophilia is in our built environment. We try and create buildings that are essentially quite open in some aspects, while also having the ability to close back down to control the sense of space. So having windows, natural light, cross ventilation, something to kind of look at, experience the passing of the day, and also to have a connection to outside.
Well, the fundamental thing when you start designing a house is to think about how the house can relate to the site that it's on. One of the ways of connecting the house to the site is by framing views of particularly important parts or places that you feel should be an integral part of the experience of living in a house, and connecting with those parts from the inside. So by framing them and by making them an important part of the experience of living in the house.